गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टेक अ न्यू टॉपिक फ्रॉम पेपर वन, दैट इज़ वेस्ट वाटर, एंड इट इज़ फ्रॉम द एमएससी ईवीएस सेमेस्टर थर्ड पेपर वन, दैट इज़ 301 यूनिट वन, रिलेटेड टू द वेस्ट वाटर ट्रीटमेंट प्रोसेस. एंड द टॉपिक दैट इज़ वेस्ट वाटर. सो वॉट इज़ अ वेस्ट वाटर? So you can say that how you are going to define it. Wastewater is any water that has been contaminated by the human use. So any water which has been contaminated by human use is said to be the wastewater, and this wastewater is used from any combination of domestic, industrial, commercial or agriculture activities. Here you can find out certain images of the wastewater. So the wastewater is collected to the sewer, and sewer then it is dumped into another sewer main tank. And so here you can find out the wastewater, from where this wastewater comes from, and how it can be treated, and then they, after the particular treatment, they are subjected to a certain natural resources. So these are the pictures of the wastewater. So here they are drained out. So these are the pictures of the wastewater. So in the pictures we have seen the wastewater contain many impurities, and the wastewater receives different types of impurities. For example, for bathroom water, normally the water used in the bathroom may get soap and other soluble and insoluble impurities. While the kitchen, you can also find out in the kitchen, water will be wasted from the sink along with the food, sometimes vegetables and other impurities, like sometimes detergent as well as oils are also present in it. So such water which is drained out from house or any other point of use through traps or gully traps, you can say that. So this water, used water, is now termed as the wastewater. So domestic water is wastewater, is also called as the sewage water, and it also, this wastewater also is liberated from the industrial waste. So you can say that wastewater may be the domestic wastewater or the industrial wastewater. Sometimes agriculture waste is also included in it. So the wastewater from the bathroom or from the kitchen or from the domestic purpose, the wastewater which is generated by the domestic purposes, they are said to be the sewage wastewater or sewage water. So the wastewater, it may be either domestic wastewater or the industrial wastewater. So domestic wastewater is also called as the sewage water. And a system of wastewater collection is provided. A network of pipelines collecting wastewater. मतलब ये जितना भी वेस्ट वाटर होता है वो वेस्ट वाटर कलेक्ट किया जाता है एक नेटवर्क थ्रू, पाइपलाइंस थ्रू, फ्रॉम डिफरेंट एरियाज, अलग अलग एरिया से थ्रू पाइपलाइंस ये कलेक्ट किया जाता है, और उस पाइपलाइंस को हम क्या बोलते हैं, सीवरेज, SEWERAGE, सीवरेज सिस्टम बोलते हैं हम उसे. सीवरेज सिस्टम विच इज मेंटेन बाय लोकल अथॉरिटी लाइक नगर पंचायत और द म्युनिसिपलिटीज. सो यू कैन से दैट दिस वेस्ट वाटर विच इज प्रोवाइडेड शुड बी कलेक्टेड थ्रू अ पाइपलाइंस, एंड देन These wastewater are collected from different areas, and like they are said to be the sewerage system. So the water which is collected from these sources or wastewater which is collected, they cannot be directly disposed of into the natural resources. It should be first collected, then it should be treated, and after maintaining a particular standards of a particular water, then it is to be disposed of in any type of natural water bodies. So it should maintain a standards for the disposal of wastewater. So it should go through certain standards. So what are the standards? India normally follows the BIS standards. BIS stands for Bureau of Indian Standards. So India follows the BIS standards. What is BIS? BIS is nothing but the Bureau, BUREAU, Bureau of Indian Standards. What is BIS? That is Bureau of Indian Standards. And BIS is the national standard body of India, and it is established under the BIS Act 2016 for the harmonious development of activities. So you can say that it is one of the standard. They have set up a certain standard, and this wastewater should fulfill all this standard, and after this water can be disposed of in the natural resources. So the BIS standards, this covers some legal provision for the disposal of wastewater anywhere on the land, specifying tolerance limit. Anywhere means they have to follow the BIS standards before the disposal on land, anywhere on the land if they want to dispose it, specifying the tolerance limit. They have specified certain tolerance limit, and they have to go according to this tolerance limit only for each of the characteristic parameters of the wastewater. So each and every parameters of the wastewater is to be specified over here, and it should be according to this limit itself. So India, like country, they used to follow the standards, that is the BIS standards. So BIS standards should be followed for the disposal of the wastewater. So what are the different parameters which is to be considered, and what are the different tolerance limit, that we have to see in detail. So from the domestic use, certain wastewater is generated, and this wastewater should not be disposed of. So it should be first treated, and then it should maintain according to the BIS standards, and should satisfy all the limits of the specified limits of the BIS standards, and then it should be disposed of. So the wastewater is treated using the physical, chemical, and biological method. So we have to make use of all these three methods for the treatment of the wastewater. So wastewater is already generated from the industry or the domestic uses, or the, you can say that sewers. So the wastewater should be treated using these three methods, that is physical, chemical, and the biological method. Now coming up to the treatment of wastewater is done normally by the three categories. What are the three categories? You know, right? First is said to be the primary treatment, second is the secondary treatment, and the third one is said to be the tertiary treatment. Sometimes it is also said to be the advanced wastewater treatment. So we have to now treat the water, and that is why it is said to be the wastewater treatment. So it is one of the method which is to be followed before the disposal of the wastewater. Now coming up to the collection of the wastewater. So how does this wastewater comes to the treatment plant? So all the pipes which are laden with the gravity and the wastewater is collected from each houses by street lines and in turns they dispose their wastewater to the main sewer. So through the this water is collected from the each houses by street lines and then they are disposed their wastewater to the main sewer, and from this main sewer it is discharged into the sump, or sometimes it is attached with the pump. That's why it is said to the sewer pumping station. So what is sewer? Sewer is nothing but the feces, jise hum Marathi mein mal bhi bolte hain, ya sab Hindi mein mal bolte hain. So it is nothing but the feces and the waste which is present in the water, and then it is finally disposed into the natural drainage, or it is reused after the required degree of treatment. So this waste is collected from the domestic waste water as a waste water, domestic waste water. Now it's reached to a plant, and then here all these three type of treatment like primary, secondary and tertiary treatment will takes place. Now coming up to the next slide, that is wastewater treatment plant. So here the wastewater is already generated, it is collected, and then now it reaches the treatment plant. And you know that this treatment plant is consisting of several units, and these units are made for each and every unit function is totally different from one another, and it is these units may include, that is screening chamber, grid chamber, primary settling tanks, biological treatment units, secondary settling tanks, sometimes it is attached to the sludge digester, and sludge drying bed. So you can say that the wastewater treatment plant consisting of various units like screen chamber, grid chamber, primary settling tanks, biological treatment units, secondary settling tanks, sludge digester and sludge drying bed. So today we are going to discuss it one by one, and the function of each and every unit varies from one to another. So we are going to describe it one by one. We know that the treatment of wastewater is broadly classified into the three categories. You know that the first one is the primary treatment, second one is the secondary treatment, and the third one it is said to be tertiary or the advanced wastewater treatment. So coming up to the first category, that is the primary wastewater treatment. So it is also said to be the physical treatment process. So it is the first step in the wastewater treatment, and here in primary treatment the large suspended floating or settleable solids, the large particles are removed from the wastewater, and here you can say that the more complex compounds are broken up and converted into the simple forms. So you can say that more complex compound get converted into the simpler ones, simpler form by means of decomposition. And the primary treatment, it normally includes screens, grit chamber and primary sedimentation tank. So you can say that the primary treatment mainly includes screens, grit chamber and primary sedimentation tank. And This is also said to be, you know it, it is said to be the physical process. Physically, we are going to remove the suspended contaminants from the wastewater. So here, we are removing the suspended contaminated from the wastewater. So this is the first step in the treatment of the wastewater. Always remember, during this treatment, primary, we are removing the suspended or large particles which is present inside the wastewater. As we have already seen that the primary treatment includes screen, grit chamber and the primary sedimentation tank. So, we are going to see these screens. What are screens and what are their functions? So screens normally that are used for the removal of floating matter of large size. So the main purpose of the installation of the screen is to remove the floating matter, of the large size particles or large size matters, such as it may be rags, it may be papers or the plastic which are floating on the surface of the water or wastewater. If such materials are not removed, then what will happen? They will choke up the small pipes and they will affect seriously the working of the sewage system. So, in order to prevent the pump from being possible damage, we have to remove these materials or certain matters which are floating on the wastewater by means of screens. So this floating matter are removed maybe manually or mechanically from the screen. So screen is one of the first step of the primary wastewater treatment, and in this screen, installation is done, and this installation of screen, they are used to remove the floating matter of the large size. And this may be rags, paper, plastic, etc. The location, sometimes its classification, design, disposal of the screening and other factors. These all factors are considered according to the type of the wastewater treatment plant. Now coming up to the next point under the primary wastewater treatment, that is the grit chamber. So you know that grit chamber, it is also known as the grit channels or the grit basin. And what is the main function of the grit chamber? It is to remove grit, sand and other inorganic matters from the sewage. So certain sewage, if they contain certain inorganic particles, then these inorganic particles, grits and sand, should be removed from the grit by means of the grit chamber. And the main purpose, location, again design, it varies from plant to plant. Next is the primary sedimentation tank. For today, this much is enough. See you in the next lecture on Monday, with continuing the same topic. Thank you. Thank you for watching. Before leaving, I would like you to see how does a screening takes place. So here screen is used. So if there is any floating matter which is present in the water, they are screened out. So here screening is done, and after that the water passes from one chamber to the another chamber by somewhere the screen bars, which is consisting of the steel, is utilized. And here in this case, second case, you can find it out here, the inorganic matter which is present inside the water, they are removed by means of the grit. So here grit is a grit particles, small particles, they are settled due to the gravity and they are separated. Sometimes the fats, oil and grease, they normally floats on the surface of the water. So this is also removed. So here screen and grit, both things you have seen. For today, this much is enough. See you on Monday. Thank you.